pretty good. Maybe a little nose heavy. It's pretty level.
Yeah, it's smooth.
Wobbling a little bit. So if it's walking back and forth like that,
this just could be a thermal up there.
I was wondering if I can tune that out with the gyro.
Yeah, I'm sure you could.
I just adjusted the gyro, so.
You'll know when you're going full speed if it rocks. Behaves.
Whoopsie. A little more airspeed, I think, to do that roll. I always forget on the EDF that I can roll either way equally, like in a Cuban and stuff, versus a prop plane. Mm-hmm. It doesn't rotate as well, the opposite. A little squirrely up there. It's moving around kind of weird.
Well, we get thermals out here all the time.
Awesome. Thanks for helping me get it going, Ken. I was a little hesitant to mess with it.
Woo. 21.8. That's still higher than a LiPo. Amps.
I miss it.
Yeah, I'm listening.
Definitely flies different than my 90. So responsive. Oh, I love that. That's fun.
You're not even close to 18 yet.
Jesus, kid.
It's running 20 degrees cooler, too.
Yeah, that is a big difference, I just think.
Still cruising.
So that's 7 minutes.
You're 6.5 on the video.
I might have started earlier because I was messing around a bit. Birds. Careful. That's where you get that death spiral.
So I wouldn't worry until you're actually getting into 18.
Doggy.
11 G's.
So much cooler. He's running 199 before 200. Sliding. Oh.
Low voltage?
Yep.
Put your gear down. I'm sorry, you're only at 9 minutes.
Can't. Better than that?
No, 8 or 9 is about my normal too.
Whoa! I'm out of battery.
Just be nice and smooth. It's not going to drop off like a normal LiPo. Drop your landing gear. Go ahead and go down on the other end. Plenty of voltage. Okay, you're good. Beautiful. See, you don't have to panic with this battery either.
That is nice. So what happened?
Your low voltage cutoff.
Cutoff.
On the ESC is set higher than what you have it on the transmitter. So it's probably set for like 3 volts.
Oh, in the
ESC.
Oh, yeah, in the ESC.